a few days now since the state opted to ban bath salts and synthetic pot in South Carolina, but so far, not all the law enforcement agencies are willing to make arrests and file charges in those cases. News 4's Mike McCormick is live and local from our Spartanburg newsroom. Mike, why the hesitation?
Well, Michael Dehek says it's because the law is new. Some law enforcement agencies say they need clarification, while others say they don't.
We're excited that that ban's in place.
The Cherokee County Sheriff says his deputies are ready to charge anyone caught with the so-called designer drugs known as bath salts and synthetic pot.
We also begin to push our guys out into the field to start spot checking our convenience stores.
He says the next step is sending in undercover deputies because the stores appear to be out of stock.
We wonder where it's went. We hope they hadn't pulled it off into a back room and going to still, you know, attempt to try to sell it.
The charge will be possession of a Schedule I controlled substance, just like cocaine or marijuana.
Later, if a court overturns it, you know, reduce it down to a lesser charge, we'll deal with that. But from our standpoint, we're going to let folks know that, you know, we're going to go ahead and move forward with the law.
That's how it is in Greenville County and Anderson. In Anderson County, it's a case-by-case basis. But in Spartanburg County, a sheriff's office spokesman says the agency is waiting on guidelines from the Attorney General's office. And Spartanburg Public Safety has decided to simply confiscate the substances and wait until they're positively identified through testing before issuing a warrant.
It's really increased our call volume.
The growing abuse of these substances is the reason Cherokee County isn't willing to wait.
We're hoping that we don't charge anybody, but we want the public to know that if we catch you with it, we're going to charge you.
And SLED has asked the Attorney General's office for some guidance on this issue. The Attorney General's office is researching the law right now and plans to issue some new information soon. Mike McCormick, WIFF News 4, live tonight in the Spartanburg newsroom.